Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the inaugural recipient of the Global Citizen Award, World Economic Forum founder and executive chairman, Professor Klaus Schwab.
Dear friends, just imagine a prime minister who, as you have seen, takes his bicycle to go to the office. If he has to make a longer distance, yes, he has a car, but it's a 12-year-old second-hand Volvo, and he is driving himself. Every week going to the school, a school of immigrant children, to teach them history. Where do you find still such a prime minister in the world? You find it in the Netherlands, and it's Mark Rutte. Mark, you have a triple role. First, of course, you are the prime minister of the Netherlands, and the Netherlands, even a small country, but still belonging to the 20, not to the G20, but to the 20 most important economies in the world. But you play a key role in the politics of your country since 10 years, having been nominated prime minister in 2010 and having been before engaged in business and in politics, of course. But you are also a solid rock in Europe. Thank you for providing a certain stability, particularly during a very challenging time for Europe, where we have to manage Brexit. And finally, we should not underestimate the significant role the Netherlands is playing on the international scene. You are one of the big donors. You are at the forefront in terms of food security, water, gender, and so on. Mark Rutte, you are a very private man. And when I did my research about you, it's very difficult to find data. But someone, it was the former president of the European Parliament, said, you are a cool man. And I said, you are one of the longest serving politicians and prime ministers in Europe. But I was told by an authoritative source, you are also probably the best looking prime minister in Europe. But much more important, particularly in our world of today, you are a principled man. And I would say we have two categories of politicians. The first categories are those who are driven by a radar system, which means they send out signals, and then they determine their behavior according to the signals they get back. But you are not a radar man. You are a compass man. Someone who has clear values, who follows his values. So you are a real statesman. So it's a great honor and pleasure for me, as the first inaugural recipient, to hand over to you on behalf of the Atlantic Council the Global Citizen Award 2019. Thank you.
Klaus, esteemed members of the Atlantic Council, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for bestowing on me one of the Global Citizens Awards for 2019. It is indeed a great honor and a great privilege. I must confess, though, that I'm actually a man of habit and tradition. To give you an example, I was born and raised in the city of The Hague. I still live there, and I have no intention to move anywhere else. So some of my best friends had a hard time picturing me as a trendsetting global citizen. But as you pointed out, Professor Schwab, dear Klaus, this prize is all about strengthening international and especially transatlantic relations. And yes, that is close to my heart. It is a fundamental truth that transatlantic cooperation makes us stronger than when we are apart. And that's not rocket science, but simple common sense, as world history since 1945 has shown. Perhaps the most important lesson I've learned in my years as Prime Minister of one of the world's most outward-looking trading countries is that national interests are often best served by international cooperation. And this is true when it comes to free and fair world trade. It's true in the field of safety and security, with NATO as a prime example, serving the interests of all member states, including the US. But it's also true when we look at the SDGs or at the Paris Climate Agreement. The late Kofi Annan once said, "I'm often asked what can people do to become a good global citizen. And I reply that it begins in your own community." So what we do at home and how we operate abroad are indeed connected. And if we do the right things, the right way, in the right order, together, then suddenly, 1 + 1 can add up to 3. I had applause here in my text, but you're not responding. Thank you. Now, it's almost a cliche to say that the global balance of power is changing rapidly. But that's the thing with cliches. They are true, and we have to deal with that reality. When I was a guest of this great Atlantic Council in Washington last July, I had the opportunity to speak about this at length. And my key message remains that in today's world, it's in our own interest and in our common interest to keep the transatlantic bond strong and vibrant. Because we need each other to safeguard our democratic and free societies, to protect and bolster free and fair world trade, and last but not least, to make the post-war multilateral system fit for purpose once again. Because the UN, meeting this week here in New York, but also NATO and the WTO, were all grounded on the principles of a bipolar world. A time when there were clear boundaries between East and West and between a first and a third world. And since then, reality has changed. But the underlying system has not evolved to keep up. And that's causing problems and friction. Today, we live in a multipolar and volatile world, a world of shifting coalitions. And it's up to us, the responsible politicians of today, to make sure we respond to this new reality by making all the necessary changes and improvements without throwing away out the baby with the bathwater. And I believe this is one of the main tasks we face across the Atlantic region. Ladies and gentlemen, when I heard that the Atlantic Council had been kind enough to make me a global citizen and that the ceremony would take place on Wall Street, my thoughts immediately turned to the Dutch woman whose name is engraved in a 9/11 monument just a few blocks from here. Ingeborg Laribi was only 42 years old when she died on that horrific day that reshaped an era. She truly was a global citizen, born to Dutch parents, building a life for herself here in New York with friends all over the world. In her obituary in the New York Times, she was eloquently described as native of the Netherlands, citizen of everywhere. It's a thought that should appeal to us all, because wherever we come from, we all gain from an international outlook and an open mind. And so I see this honor not as a lifetime achievement or a lifetime achievement award, but as an incentive prize. Thank you.